In this video, we'll be taking a look at the differences between the psychological profiles in the Mass Effect trilogy. These backgrounds are Soul Survivor, War Hero, and Ruthless. I'll show you how these backgrounds impact gameplay and unique dialogue. Keep watching to see it all. What's up, everyone? Big Dan here. Before we begin, you should know I have over 150 Mass Effect Trilogy videos on my channel, including hidden scenes, rare choices, lore videos, and guides. So if you want to see more Mass Effect, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss any new videos. Without further ado, let's dive right in. During character creation, there are two different types of backgrounds you will select for your character: pre-service history and psychological profile. The pre-service histories, Earthborn, Colonist, and Spacer, determine what happened to Shepard before he or she joined the Alliance military. We won't be talking much about those particular backgrounds in this video. Today, we're focusing on the psychological profiles, which are Soul Survivor, War Hero, and Ruthless. These determine Shepard's claim to fame in the military, as well as the leadership style for the commander. If you're expecting the psychological profiles to have a massive impact on the game, you're going to be disappointed. They are mostly meant for role-playing and character-building purposes. That being said, there are some minor differences in morality scores, as well as some unique dialogue that is worth exploring. So let's dive into the details for each background, starting with Soul Survivor. In the 2170s, humanity was in the early stages of establishing a colony on AKUZE. When the Colonial Pioneer Team went radio silent, the Alliance sent in a recon unit to investigate. During this scouting mission, the recon team was attacked by Thresher Maws and all soldiers except Shepard were killed. As the Codex entry says, "You survived while all those around you fell, and now you alone are left to tell the tale." Now, I could go on a huge tangent right now about how another soldier named Corporal Toombs also survived the Thresher Maw attack, but we'll touch on that more in the unique dialogue section of this video. For now, just know that a Soul Survivor Shepard is someone who will do whatever it takes to survive, which brings me to the gameplay benefits. Each psychological profile grants you a bonus to your morality score at the beginning of the game. Soul Survivors are granted an equal amount of Paragon and Renegade points, making them a good middle-of-the-road character who can lean either way. So if you don't know whether you want to be a Paragon or a Renegade yet, then Soul Survivor is your best bet. Let's talk about the War Hero. As humanity began to establish colonies in Citadel space, other races, particularly the Batarians, started to get angry over how quickly humans were expanding their territories. The colony of Elysium became a shining example of successful human civilization, and as such it became a target. A coalition of pirate gangs mounted a massive raid on Elysium, which became known as the Skillion Blitz. During this attack, the War Hero Shepard risked his own life to single-handedly defeat the pirate gangs and drive them off Elysium. For his efforts, Shepard was awarded the Star of Terra commendation and became a hero of the Alliance. War Hero is a great psychological profile to pick if you want to play as a Paragon character, since you'll receive a bonus of shiny blue morality points at the start of the game. Finally, we have the Ruthless background. In retaliation for the Skillion Blitz, the Alliance mounted an assault on Torfin in 2178. Torfin was a major base of operations for Batarian slavers, who were heavily fortified when the Alliance attacked. The Ruthless Shepard was sent in to drive the Batarians out of their hidey holes. Shepard approached the situation with a take-no-prisoners, win-at-any-cost mentality. Three-quarters of Shepard's unit died in the assault, and when the Batarians eventually surrendered, Shepard ordered them all to be executed. As you can probably guess, the Ruthless background grants a bonus to Renegade points, and I think it also pairs well with the Colonist pre-service history, which saw Shepard's parents dying in a Batarian raid on Mindwar in 2170. And that's the general overview of the backgrounds. Throughout the game, you'll get some unique dialogue from a variety of characters based on your psychological profile. Some examples include Emily Wong on the Citadel and Ethan Jong on Pharos.
"I've read your file. If anyone is going to uncover corruption here, it's the hero of the Skillion Blitz. I read about the Siege of Torfin, sending your men to their deaths, shooting slavers as they tried to surrender. I need someone who isn't afraid to get their hands dirty, someone who'll do what needs to be done. That's you. According to your file, you survived back on AKUZE when everyone else in your squad got killed. If anyone can find the worst elements of the Citadel and live to tell about it, it's you."
"I found some interesting facts about you in the exogenic database. I know what you did during the Blitz, but your heroics aren't needed here. I found some interesting facts about you in the exogenic database. I know what you did on Torfin. There's no reason for this to get bloody. I found some interesting facts about you in the exogenic database. I know what happened on AKUZE. This doesn't have to end like that.
Unlike the pre-service history backgrounds, which each have a unique side mission in Mass Effect 1, there are no special missions based on your psychological profile. However, each psych profile background does have unique dialogue in an individual side mission in Mass Effect 1. While the missions themselves can be accessed by any background, the unique dialogue will only show up if you have a specific background. For Soul Survivors, this mission is UNC Dead Scientists. For War Heroes, it's UNC Espionage Probe, and Ruthless characters have unique dialogue during UNC Major Kyle. Let's take a look at the unique dialogue for each of those, starting with Ruthless. During UNC Major Kyle, Shepard has to deal with a former Alliance officer who's made himself leader of a biotic cult. It's believed that Kyle is responsible for the deaths of two Alliance negotiators sent to deal with him. For Ruthless characters, Major Kyle was Shepard's commanding officer during the Siege of Torfin, so you will get unique dialogue throughout the mission.
Shepard, this is Admiral Hackett with Alliance Command. We've got a mission for you. Major Kyle, your commanding officer Torfin, has set up a small compound in a hulking eta cluster. He's attracted a number of biotic followers.
What else can you tell me about Major Kyle?
He's not the same man you served under. He feels responsible for the Alliance soldiers who died at Torfin. His psych evaluation showed he couldn't handle the stress of command anymore. He was given an honorable discharge and early retirement. We'd hoped he would get better in time, but we underestimated how far gone he was. Now it looks like it's too late.
This is a private sanctuary. Outsiders are not welcome here.
I need to talk to the man in charge. It's important.
Father Kyle wants nothing more to do with the Alliance.
My name is Commander Shepard. Major Kyle knows me. I have to speak to him.
Wait. Father Kyle will speak with you.
I know you, the Butcher of Torfin. Why have you come here, Shepard? Why can't you leave us alone?
During UNC Espionage Probe, War Heroes will have some unique dialogue with Alanis Haliot, mastermind of the Skillian Blitz.
Shepard, at last.
You have me at a disadvantage.
You don't remember me. No matter. I remember you. I never forget anyone I've fought. My name is Ilanos Haliot. I doubt you know it. Who do you think runs the Terminus Clan, Shepard, huh? Thousands of pirates, slavers, criminals of every stripe?
In most criminal organizations, it's the one who's recognized as the most successful.
That's correct. The one who kills the most men, seizes the most ships, pillages the most colonies. 3 years ago, I was the strongest. I used my influence to assemble a fleet. We would drive your kind out of the Verge.
You're the one behind the attack on Elysium.
I was the motivator, the instigator, the one who promised glory and riches for sacking the largest human colony in the cluster. The one blamed when it failed. Failed because of you. Your damnable holding action.
Side note, in the original Mass Effect, Alanis Haliot had a human character model, which was likely a mistake by the developers. Given the lore of the Skillian Blitz, it's unlikely that a human led a gang of Batarians and Turians in a major attack on a human colony. In Mass Effect Legendary Edition, Haliot's character model was changed to a Turian, which is more lore-friendly. Soul Survivors will have unique dialogue during the mission UNC Dead Scientists. I have a full video on this if you want to explore all outcomes to that quest, but basically you'll discover that the Soul Survivor isn't actually the Soul Survivor, since another member of Shepard's unit survived the Thresher Maw attack.
Shut up! You don't get to lie! You don't... Shepard? My God! Shepard, is that you?
Corporal Toombs? But... I saw you die on AKUZE. How did you get here?
They took me, Shepard. The scientists.
You can't prove any of this. This man is delusional.
See, they were running tests on the Thresher Maws. They let those things hit us just to watch and study. I woke up in a holding cell. The scientists were delighted I'd survived. Now they had someone to run tests on.
What did they do to you, Toombs?
You can't believe Toombs. He doesn't have any proof. I demand a fair trial.
He was there, you bastard. He knows the truth. They're part of some organization, Cerberus, that runs secret tests like this. They treated me like a lab animal. This man deserves to die, Shepard. For you, for me, for everyone else in the unit. Are you with me?
Typically, there is an option to shoot Corporal Toombs during this quest. However, if you're a sole survivor, you will not be able to shoot Toombs, which I think is the only case in the trilogy where the psychological profile impacts your available choices in a quest. After Mass Effect 1, the psychological profiles take a major backseat, with only a sprinkling of unique dialogue thrown in here and there, mostly in Mass Effect 3. Here are a few examples.
So why the jokes?
Because Edie says that according to your armor's metabolic scans, you're under more stress now than during the Skillian Blitz. Like, more than AKUZE, where Thresher Maws ate the rest of your squad.
Admiral, we're in deep and the Prothean VI will be in the safest part of the station. Don't hold back.
This isn't Elysium, Shepard. I don't need a hero.
Anything from Shepard's military record that you'd like to call out?
Many in the Alliance consider Shepard a war hero. On Elysium, for example, Shepard single-handedly repelled an attack and saved the entire squad.
Thank you for your presentation, and to all who spoke.
So there you have it. The differences, gameplay changes, and unique dialogue of all psychological profiles in the Mass Effect trilogy. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe to Big Dan Gaming for more Mass Effect and RPG videos. I also have a bunch more Mass Effect videos, so why don't you check out another one, like this one I've linked on the screen. Until next time, this has been Big Dan. I should go.